Hi, today we will be testing the Dirt Devil Fusion M611 robotic vacuum cleaner. You are watching a Fanatic Report. Hi, my name is Lars Muis and I'll be doing an independent review of the Dirt Devil Fusion M611 robotic vacuum cleaner. This unit is just under $150 or 150 euros and is one of the vacuums in the lower segment. If you want to see the test data, you can at any point go to the website fanatic.report. At first, actually, let's have a look what's inside the box. So of course we have the unit itself. The unit has no buttons except this switch here on the side to actually turn it on or turn it off. And there's a hole here to charge the device, even though it's got the docking station as well to charge it. So then the device comes with these two brushes. You need to attach those at the bottom yourself. Then it comes with a battery pack. You need to install this yourself as well. There is a docking station that has got three different buttons. That's something that's actually quite exceptional. There are not that much manufacturers that have buttons on the charging station. So there's a button to start cleaning straight away. There's a button to start cleaning in 24 hours. And there is this button to actually start cleaning after the device is charged. So then the device comes with these plugs and these screws to attach the docking station to the wall. And of course there is an AC adapter to power the docking station. And there is the manual. So according to the manufacturer, it's about 1.8 kilograms, the device, and it can hold up to 240 milliliters of dust. So if you take the lid off, then you have here the dust bin that stores all the dust. So it should go back to the docking station automatically. And after 5 hours of charging, it should work about 1 hour throughout the house without falling off any stairs or bumping into any obstacles. So let's see if this actually works.
When testing on laminate, we reached a sound level of 65 dB, which is quite a lot. Testing with rice ends up at 92% of all rice being vacuumed. Crumbs up to 96%, that's almost everything. But with dust we see this vacuum fall short. Only 44% is actually being vacuumed. Testing on short pile carpets shows even less. 60% rice, 52% crumbs, and 24% of dust is vacuumed. Still not too bad. On long pile carpets though, we see the device falling short. It only reaches up to 4%, that's the lowest we can get. If you have a long pile carpet, don't use this robot to clean it. We also see that on long pile carpets, the brushes bend and become less effective. In the real life test, we see the device going through the room. Vacuuming under the chairs. It's avoiding carpets and cables in this case, but not always, as you will see later. We can also see why there are plugs and screws to attach the docking station. Without it, it will move the docking station throughout the room. To clean larger areas, the device starts to vacuum around in a certain spot. It does this quite often. The space under curtains is also being taken care of. There's an edge mode to go around certain furniture, and it will also go underneath the couch. And even in the dark, the device knows its way around. There are also a couple of things that are not working as it should. The device gets stuck on cables. It needs help to continue. Mm-hmm. Same with carpet, it won't go any further. When it comes to glasses with water, well, never leave them there. Also the vase, don't let this vacuum come near it. A black area might entrap your robot. You can fix this by changing the switches on the bottom. This, however, means it will fall from the stairs. So the device can also not fall from the stairs, if the switches are set properly. But even then, it sometimes gets stuck. Oops. When it's finished, it goes backwards to the docking station. This is not always working. It will try it again, but not always reach it. However, in some cases it does work.
Altogether, this device gets 5.9 points for accessories, 5.4 points for cleaning, and 5.0 points for the real-life test in the living room. The accessories are not as important as the other tests, so it actually weighs less. This results in a total of 5.3 points. That's not that much, but for a device in the lower segment, not bad. And this will bring the device to a 5th place. Just after the Daredevil Spider and just before the Daredevil Spider 2.0. So if you want a clean house, just spend a little bit more money and go for a vacuum in the middle segment. You'll find some vacuums there that do clean your house quite well. However, if you don't mind vacuuming yourself and you don't mind searching for your robot down then, and you're looking for a nice toy, then this robot might be just for you. YouTube, thank you for watching. See the other robots reviewed on this channel or on the website fanatic.report. And you can also see the individual test clips of the laminate and the carpet test there. And you can compare the robots to others. Don't forget to subscribe or help a friend by sharing this video with them. See you next time!